Hi everyone. Well, the last couple of weeks have obviously been dominated by the devastating earthquake in Canterbury on the 4th of September. I was sound asleep in Dunedin when the quake woke me up. Obviously there was no damage that far south, and certainly we were very grateful for that. One of the things I've been amazed about is the fact that there was no loss of life, particularly when you compare that with other earthquakes around the world. Los Angeles in 1989, where hundreds died, Kobe in 1995, where 6,000 people lost their lives in a city of apparently similar structure and similarly modern. So really we are very thankful, but that's little comfort now to the people of Christchurch and Canterbury who are having to rebuild in the face of enormous damage that's been done. So I've been really impressed with the way in which the authorities, the civil defence, fire service, all of our community have rallied around, and the cleanup has really begun. But it's going to be a long journey. Last night the government passed legislation to enable things to happen quite quickly and not be slowed down by red tape, so that will really help. But on behalf of the people of Dunedin, I certainly extend our good wishes, and anything that we can do, obviously we will be, but all the best for that recovery. In late August, I hosted the Prime Minister in Dunedin, and for some time I've wanted to get him down there in his capacity as Minister of Tourism and to go out onto the Otago Peninsula and see some of the fantastic scenery that we have, and that has certainly attracted the attention of tourists right around the world. One of the world's leading biologists, Dr. David Bellamy, described the Otago Peninsula is one of the great untouched places in the world for its flora and fauna. So I was really delighted to be able to take John out, show him the albatross colony and a fantastic little place on Tairoa Head called Nature's Wonders, which is a private farm owned by the same family for a long time. And we went on the little eight-wheel machines they have out there called Argos, which took us down onto the Pacific coast, where we walked literally amongst the fur seals and the bird life, and watched the hoiho, the yellow-eyed penguin, as they were nesting in preparation for the spring and the new chicks coming. We also went to Larnac Castle, that iconic place and the only castle in New Zealand. So the Barker's family hosted us there. We had a great time. The other reason for the visit was for the Prime Minister to give out the awards for the Otago Daily Times Class Act Awards. This has been run for about the last 11 years and recognises academic and general excellence for two pupils of each of the secondary schools in Otago and Southland. So that was another really good event. Next week is Arthritis Appeal Week. And I am the head of the Parliamentary Friendship Group for Arthritis. It's something that's pretty close to my heart. I have arthritis and I live well thanks to a diet and a few pills, good exercise regime. But unfortunately, many of the 500,000 New Zealanders afflicted by arthritis are not so lucky. So an organisation like Arthritis New Zealand provides really valuable support for those people who can't cope on their own. And next week is that appeal week. They have a target of raising $500,000, and I wish them all the very best for that. Next Tuesday, the 21st of September, I'll be launching Arthritis Appeal Week with All Black Namia Tialata, who is also a strong supporter of Arthritis New Zealand. Lastly, just a reminder that my next Friday forum in Dunedin is on Friday the 24th of September. My good friend and colleague Amy Adams, the MP for Selwyn, will be the guest speaker that day. Amy's really one of our rising stars. She's the chairman of the Electoral Reform Select Committee, so that's the committee that's dealing with the MMP referendum and the replacement of the Electoral Finance Act. So she'll have quite a bit to say about that. But of course, being the MP for Selwyn, at the epicentre of the earthquake, she'll have quite a few stories about how that has affected her and her community. So look out for that Friday the 24th of September. That's all from me. Take care.